about gardening and planting seeds. First, I'm going to read you a story, and then I'm going to show you how to use the materials in your home play kit. This story is called Bear and Bunny Grow Tomatoes by Bruce College Mack. Bear and Bunny Grow Tomatoes. One winter, Bear decided to grow tomatoes, and so did Bunny. In spring, Bear began by digging a place for his tomato garden. Bunny didn't want to waste time preparing anything. He poured his packet of seeds on the hard, weedy ground. Bear took care to rake all the clumps, stones, and weeds out of his soil. Bunny put up a sign and went for a folding chair. It doesn't look like he's taking very good care of his garden, but Bear looks like he's taking really good care of his garden. Bear worked hard pulling out all the weeds and hauling away all the stones from his garden. Bunny just made some lemonade in his blender and found his favorite book. Then he got a big pillow and went out to watch his garden grow. Bear made small seed holes and dropped a few seeds into one, really carefully. Bunny dropped some lemon seeds as he's just reading a book and relaxing. Soon little green sprouts were popping up in Bear's garden. But Bunny couldn't be sure what was growing in his garden. Bear put in tomato sticks to help his tomatoes grow tall and straight. Bunny put in a swimming pool and invited Bear to his pool party. "Maybe some other time," said Bear. "I'm busy right now." Bear was busy taking care of his garden and making sure that his garden was going to grow and tending to it, but not Bunny. A gentle summer rain fell as Bear went out to weed his garden. Now the tomato plants were almost to the top of the sticks. In Bunny's garden, the weeds had grown almost to the top of his windows. You can tell the difference in a garden that looks nice and tended to, and then this garden, he hasn't taken care of it at all. At night, Bear slept lightly so he would be able to hear anyone who might wander uninvited into his garden. "Who's there?" he would growl. But Bunny slept like a ball of yarn. By August, Bear's plants were bursting with large, juicy tomatoes. Look at all the tomatoes that he grew from caring to it so nicely. "I know my tomatoes are here somewhere," said Bunny. He's searching, but I don't see any. Bear ran out of boxes and baskets to put his tomatoes in. "Now what will I do with all these tomatoes?" he wondered. Bear took two boxes and made his way to Bunny's yard. "I know you've been growing tomatoes too," said Bear, "but I would like to give you these. Maybe you could use a few extra." "Thank you," said Bunny. "I do have a tomato garden. I just can't find it. But when I do, the tomatoes are sure to be colossal." Bear had a very good harvest of tomatoes, and so did Bunny. Because Bear was such a nice friend and shared with Bunny, now they both have a great harvest of tomatoes. The end. So in this story, you could tell that you need to take pour the dirt into the cup. Then you're going to stick your finger in there and make a little hole, not too deep. Then you're going to open your little bag of seeds. Take a couple of those out. Put them in the hole. And lightly cover it up with some dirt. And then you have to be like Bear in the story and take care of it. Give it some water, put it in the sunlight, and make sure that you take care of it. And soon you'll see a sprout grow. And then when it gets big enough, you can plant it either in the ground or you can repot it into a bigger pot. Make sure that you take care of it so that it will grow. All right, boys.